Hey guys, Nathan here, Mom's Crew here, today bringing you a Domination on the map Stadium, or Takeoff. Takeoff is a remake of the map Stadium from Black Ops 1, so you could literally say this is a DLC remake of a DLC map from Black Ops 1. Kind of weird thing to say, but anyways, today we'll be using the MP7 suppressed with extended clip like usual, and this is kind of like my first, or my fourth or fifth game on this map, so yeah. I kind of already know this map, obviously, because I played Black Ops 1 before. But anyways, today we have three things to talk about. Number one is a little real-life issue, particularly to the people that lead people on, guys or girls. Number two is the map review of this map, Takeoff. Tell you all the tactics, what I think about it, you know, a scale of 1 to 10, how good this map is, so on. And the third topic, we're going to reach abroad and think, maybe, let's see what... What do you think Call of Duty Ghost has a DLC has to offer us? So yeah, guys. Anyways, sit back, relax, hope you enjoy, and let's get started. Anyways, in my personal life has been going okay lately. It's not been doing the best because constant crap's been going on. Like, pretty much just to sort it out. Two or three people in my life just love to play with my feelings, and they know who they are. And if you're watching this right now, well, you kind of earned yourself a video, but anyways, to the main topic here, leading people on. Now, I know for a fact I don't lead people on, because I'm not the most attractive guy out there. I'll be honest with you, I'm not going to be a little douchebag, oh, I'm the hottest dude ever, look at my muscles, I'm so cool. No, I'm not a tool, I don't really like that behavior, but basically, people who lead people on, by the way guys, probably because I don't know what leading on is pretty much when some person just constantly, you know, some person likes another person, but that person that the person likes just keeps throwing compliments and nice things and sending mixed feelings or mixed signals, you know, like, oh, I do, she really, he or she must really like me if she's saying these nice things, and then the person turns around and just starts flat out ignoring you or saying negative things about you. That is called leading people on. And I have many things to say about the guys and girls out there that lead people on. For number one, it's not right. Whoever thinks it's right and whoever thinks it's right to joke about is ridiculous. If you do joke about leading people on, like, oh, look at that girl I just led on a couple weeks ago. Haha, it's so funny how she's so sad now. You know, and it works for guys too, guys, girls. But it's ridiculous. It's so cold-hearted. Like, why in the world would you lead somebody on? If you're not interested, just freaking tell them. You know, say, hey, I really don't like you, but we can still be friends. I mean, it's better being friendzoned than freaking led on, I'll be honest with you. If you have somebody crushing on you right now, either a guy or a girl, just, and you kind of are just, like, you're not interested, just say you're not interested. Just say, you know, I really like the stuff you're saying about me. I really like talking to you, but I'm not interested right now. If we can still be friends, you know, I'm fine being your friend. It's just, you know, I don't have feelings towards you, and I hope you understand that. Just say that, and it'd make the person may be sad, but they're not going to be as sad as if they were getting led on, like, 2 months, 3 months in, you know what I mean? Because if somebody thinks you like them, and you really don't, it's going to crush them, and it's going to hurt them. And I've been through that a couple times within the past couple months, and I just want to say that people who lead people on, you're gonna get, karma's gonna hit you in the ass, I'm not gonna lie. And there's no simpler or nicer way to say it. If you're gonna be people like that, you're gonna treat people like that or lead them on and not just tell them, you know, like, oh, I'm not interested or something like that, then you deserve the treatment that you're giving other people. I'm not a philosopher, I'm not a little social person, I'm social, I'm not like a psychiatrist or anything, but it's not right. So if you think it's funny to lead people on, or, you know, lead people on and then crush people like that and start joking around with your friends about it, which, by the way, I am kind of pointing out one specific person, but no one knows who this certain person is, so it's all good. But if you do that, you are heartless, you are cold-hearted, you are so harsh, you're like, that's terrible. But anyways, enough with the emotional stuff. It's not going to happen because we could save an episode for that later. We're going to start talking about this map in particular, Takeoff. When I first saw the map, I was like, is this the Stadium remake? Or is this, another map like Pod, which is a complete cluster of just random crap that I don't know. Because first, when I got this map pack, I thought Pod was the remake of Stadium, and I was like, oh my god, Treyarch, you completely screwed this map up. But apart from this, this is the map Stadium, pretty much. Now, I do love, unlike Gdig, I do love Treyarch for remaking this map, because this is complete copy and pasted with different, you know, obviously different settings. I love copy and pasted DLC maps. A map like Dig is not completely copy and pasted, because it's kind of mirrored. It's kind of, it's not really made like it was in World of War. It doesn't have the same feel. This has the same feel for some weird reason, because in Black Ops 1 we're used to more modern weapons like the FAMAS, the AK-74U, the AUG, the AK-47, so it feels kind of normal now to have the MP7 and all these newer guns out on the battlefield when you're playing an older map like this. So pretty much the tactics on this map, nothing much to say. If you played Black Ops 1, you know this map, you know the spawns, you know everything about this map. Spawning, if you're on A, they spawn on C, if you're on C, they spawn on A, if you have A and B, A and C capped, they spawn on B. And the main objective at the start of this game is to rush B, because whoever has B in the long run is going to have it for the whole game, unless you have a team that just sucks nuts. But, yeah. So, run for B. Once you get B, you can focus on getting your home flag, and yeah. So, there's not much to say about this map. I rate it, I'd say, an easy 9 out of 10. This map has, you know, it's familiar, everybody knows it, and if you haven't played Black Ops 1, you will adjust to this map really quick. It's not that hard to learn. And when I first got Black Ops 1 to use, and I got Stadium, it only took me about a game or two to learn it. So yeah, for all you new players out there to Call of Duty that started Black Ops 2 as their first Call of Duty, you'll love this map. So yeah, final topic. It's going to be a quick one. Kind of what we have to see about Ghost DLC. I purposely kind of made this a little like at the end of the video, because there's not much things to say about DLC. And there's a VTOL warship, vertical takeoff and landing, but anyways, for DLC and Ghost, I really do hope they bring the DLC guns back, but they don't make them as hyped up as, you know, like, overrated, but really have crappy power, like the Peacekeeper. I play Core, so Core is not really good for Peacekeepers. If you're on Hardcore, oh my god, that gun's a beast. But, you know, Treyarch kind of hyped up, you know, they made everybody hyper and hyped up for the Peacekeeper, and it really shouldn't have happened like that. It's actually the balanced SMG that Treyarch should have thought of at the start. But yeah, as of maps, we should totally see more dynamic maps, you know, dynamic DLC maps in Ghost, and I'm excited. So anyways, guys, hope you guys enjoyed the gameplay/commentary. I'll see you guys later. Bye. Final score 24-6.